So we are going with separation of substances. Are you ready to see the experiments today? First the explanation part, then we shall go with the activity. What is there? First one is sublimation. What is meant by sublimation? The substance changes from solid to gas and gas to solid is called as a sublimation process. We know that the substances changes from solid to liquid, liquid to solid, or liquid to gaseous, gaseous to solid. We know that one. What happens, sir, when we are taking ice and when we heat that one, it changes into water. The water, if you keep in refrigerator, it changes into ice. We know that one. Now what we are doing here, in this, the solid substance we are taking and it changes into gaseous form, and when it cools, the gaseous form again changes into solid form. What are the things required here? The apparatus, the things required here are camphor, okay, then funnel, cotton, tripod stand, candle, matchstick, okay, little bit of salt. These are the things required to do the china dish. These are the things required for us. So here what we are doing is take a tripod stand. Okay. Now place a china dish on this tripod stand. And what we have to do here means take a tripod stand. Okay. Then place a china dish on this one, and in this we are keeping camphor and salt. What is this here? Then take a funnel and invert the funnel on this china dish. Now cover this funnel with the cotton. Means the air should not enter into this one. Now what we have to do means here put a candle. Put a candle and lit this candle. Now when this heat touches this camphor, this camphor, which is in solid part, will change into water vapor, which is in solid form, and touches this funnel. Again, when it cools, it comes back to its normal position in the solid form into china dish. So, try to understand what is sublimation. Sublimation means the substance changes from solid to gas and gas to solid is called as sublimation. What are the things required? We have to take camphor, salt, tripod stand, candle, then china dish, funnel, cotton we have to take. Now place a tripod stand. On the tripod stand you place a china dish. On this china dish you place a camphor and salt, and invert the funnel. Okay, and place it on this china dish. Now cover this hole with the cotton. Okay, so I'm writing here, this is cotton, this is funnel, this is china dish. Okay, here we are having camphor, salt, this is tripod stand, this is candle. These are the things required. Now start heating this camphor. The camphor, which is in solid form, totally it will melt and changes into water vapor form. When it cools down, again it comes back into its normal position. This is called as a sublimation process. Now I will do this experiment and I will show for you. Then you will understand clearly. Next one is about chromatography. What is this chromatography? So here we will have only one color. Now if I am making an ink, it may be black, red, blue, any sort of ink you take. I'll show you the bottle and I'll ask what is the color of this one. You'll tell this is blue color, this is red color, this is black color. But this particular color is mixture of many colors. Many colors are mixed in one color. Many colors are mixed in one color. This is called as chromatography. So here for doing this chromatography, what we have to do? See here, in my hand, you can see a chalk of different colors are there. Now, this chalk piece, on this I kept only blue color. Blue ink. On this chalk piece, I kept only blue ink. Now, you can see here, purple color was there, thick blue was there, light blue was there. When I am showing you the ink bottle, you can say that only blue color was present. But when I just put a blue color on this, see, you can see it is a mixture of three colors. It is a mixture of three colors. So you can try with black ink, you can try with red ink, you can try with blue ink. This means here, what is chromatography means? The mixture of different colors is called as chromatography. How we have to do this experiment? I'll show you practically how to do this experiment. Just wait.
One start chapandi.
So see here children, we are doing sublimation process. See in the plate what I took, camphor and salt was there in the plate, and you can see here I lit the candle. Here what we have to do means, if I take any opaque glass means you cannot see what is the process taking place here. So what I am going to do means, I am taking a transparent glass and inverted on this one. Now hold this one and just keep near the candle. Okay, when this heat will be produced to this one, slowly what will happen means you can see that the camphor converts into water vapor form. It takes time. Try to understand. If you are trying at home, take the help of your parents. Why? Because it will come to you. See, you can see the fumes are entering into the glass jar. Can you find that one? The transparent glass jar, water vapor, the fumes are converting here, and slowly the camphor is melting down because of the heat produced by the candle. Can you observe that one? How the water vapor or the fumes are forming in the glass? Slowly the camphor and the salt are melting. You can find that one. If you are doing the experiment with your hand, please hold the kerchief or something. Why? Because the heat will come to your hand, your small kids. If you are interested to do this experiment, please take the help of your parents. This is only called as sublimation process. Here you can see the solid substance slowly it is converting into water vapor form. The solid substance, so slowly you can see the fumes are coming out of the plate also. It is converting into water vapor. It is converting into water vapor. Finally, I'll show you the plate also. Nothing will be remained in the plate. Okay. Total the camphor and the salt also will melt in the plate. You can see that one.
So see here how the fumes are coming out and how the camphor was melted, only the salt particles was left over in the plate. How it was, how the water vapor is coming, water vapor coming from the plate, you see, when it cools down, how it will be converted into, what is that again, solid part, I'll show for you. See here, how the water vapor is coming out from that one. And can you see the camphor in the plate? Before I saw, showed for you 5 to 6 camphors here, but you cannot find that one. Don't touch like that. How I hold it in my hand, you don't try to hold that one. It may be hot, the plate and the, what is that, the glass beaker also. So you have to see this one. And when it cools down, when it cools down, you can see that particularly slowly, when it cools down, it changes into solid part. I told again, see here, still it is hot. See here again, I'm bringing back into, first it converted into water vapor form, again it is changed into solid form. Did you follow? This is the process of sublimation, solid to gaseous and again gaseous to solid form. It is still, it is not what is that, it is still hot, the glass is hot, so the substance is not coming out. You can see that again it is, again if I want I can melt this one. Again, I can put the candle and again, I can melt this one. So, you can see here, when it cools down, again, it will be converted into solid form. This is your sublimation process example. You can try at home. Very interesting one. Next, we are going with the chromatography. See here, I showed for you different colors of this chromatography. So, for this, what we had to do means take a chalk. Okay. Now, on this chalk, this is the blue ink. I am taking blue ink. You can take black, you can take red, whatever you are interested, you can take that. So, take this little ink, okay? And you just pour this ink at the bottom of the chalk. Like this. A mark. After that, a little is enough. No need a full chalk, you no need to pour this one. So you have to do like this. And see here, I took a little water, you had to take, not more water, little water you had to take in a beaker, and just you put this here. And after some time, up to where, up to this ink mark, what the chalk will do, it will absorb the water. What is the purpose of the chalk? It absorbs the water. We have to see that the chalk absorbs the water up to the ink mark. Up to the ink mark, we have to see that the chalk is absorbing the water. After some time, you can see different colors. Now itself, slowly you try to observe how the different colors are coming out from that one. You can see the total 3 colors. Here also you can see the changes are taking place. The changes are taking place. The color is changing. You try to observe. Slowly it is coming up. You can see 3 different colors are coming out from that one. 3 different colors. That is purple, thick blue, light blue. You try to observe. This also you can try at home. Take a chalk piece. Then take any colored ink. Red, blue, black. And find out how many colors are there in that one. Just a little water, chalk, a small mark on your chalk piece. And put that chalk in that one. You can see I did with blue ink. Here you can see 3 colors. Purple, blue and thick blue and light blue, you can see here. See how the colors are changing. The chalk is absorbing the water. And you can see the changes. Which ink I took? I took blue ink. How many colors you can see here? 3 colors you can see. Light blue, thick blue and purple color you can find in this one. So, these are the 2 experiments of sublimation and chromatography. I hope you have a lot of interest on these 2 experiments. If you are interested, you can try at home. I'll continue tomorrow. Thank you.